Hello friends. In this video, we'll take a look at a budget-friendly relay with energy monitoring, designed for installation on a DAN rail from the well-known Chinese manufacturer MOES. We'll figure out what tasks this device solves and how it differs from a circuit breaker. We'll also find out which smart home systems it can be used with and how exactly it integrates with them. In addition, we'll test how it performs as a voltage protection relay. All that coming up. But first, as usual, I'd like to ask you to give this video a like. It helps others interested in smart home technology find it, and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device: relay for installation on a DAN rail. Model: MOES 5. Interface: Zigbee 3.0. Functions as a Zigbee router. Maximum rated current: 63 amperes. Operating voltage: 90 to 250 volts. It has energy monitoring and the ability to set cutoff thresholds for key parameters: temperature, power, current, as well as low and high voltage levels. Device dimensions: 18 millimeters wide, meaning it takes up one standard module, one unit, on a DAN rail. The device comes in a branded MOES box featuring TUIA, Google Home, and Amazon Alexa logos, as well as the Zigbee interface marking. Inside the box, the relay itself and a small multilingual user manual. The case follows the standard design for devices installed in an electrical panel on a DAN rail. Width: one unit, that is 18 millimeters, like a regular circuit breaker. On the front panel, there are two LED indicators. Net: shows the status of the Zigbee network connection. Status: displays the current relay state. Next to them is a control button that allows you to manually turn the load on or off. Basic specifications are printed here as well. The manufacturer also notes that the relay only switches the live wire, L, while the neutral wire, N, passes straight through without interruption. The total depth of the device is 65.5 millimeters, with 50 millimeters being the main body. The casing is made of non-flammable matte plastic and has an IP20 protection rating, meaning it's suitable for indoor installation in an electrical panel. The two halves of the casing are fastened with rivets, so the device is non-disassemblable and not intended to be opened or repaired by the user. As I mentioned, this relay is designed for installation on a standard DAN rail. At the bottom of the case, there's a yellow spring-loaded latch. It can be pressed with a flat screwdriver to mount the relay onto the rail and then securely lock it in place. The mounting process is simple and convenient. Installation takes just a few seconds. In this slide, the relay is installed next to a regular circuit breaker, and here it's important to note one key point. The MOES 5 relay is not intended for short circuit protection. While there are smart relays on the market that combine relay and circuit breaker functions, this model belongs strictly to the category of switching devices. It controls the load, but does not provide protective functions. How can this be determined? It's simple. If the device's casing has a lever like a circuit breaker, that means there's a thermal release mechanism inside, allowing it to trip in the event of a short circuit. Usually, such models are noticeably wider, take up two or more units, and include a micromotor for remote lever operation. The MOES 5 has no lever, only a control button, so it's not a circuit breaker, but a relay. Therefore, to protect the line from short circuits, a separate circuit breaker must be installed. Now let's move on to the wiring. To demonstrate how this relay is mounted in a real electrical panel, I assembled a small demonstration setup that replicates a typical home wiring scheme. Here, the arrow indicates the main power input, the cable supplying power to the apartment or house. Phase and neutral. The phase wire, shown here in red, passes through a circuit breaker that provides overload and short circuit protection. After the breaker, the phase goes to the load. In this demo setup, it's a regular outlet. The neutral wire, blue, goes directly to the load without interruption, as in a standard wiring scheme. Now let's see how to include the relay in the existing circuit with minimal changes. To do this, the phase wire that previously went directly from the breaker to the load is moved to the relay's input terminal, LIN. From the relay's L-out terminal, the phase is sent to the load, in this case, to the outlet. Connect the neutral wire to the relay's input. It's needed for the relay's operation and for energy monitoring. Since the neutral line is common, there's no need to change anything on the load side. The in-out-output terminal is optional to use. Checking operation. After power is applied, the relay turns on, the indicators light up, and by pressing the control button, you can manually switch the load on and off. Now let's check the compatibility with smart home systems. We'll start with the basic platform, Thuya Smart. To connect the device, a gateway is required. In this case, a wired Zigbee thread version from MOES is used, with a link to its review provided in the description. The connection process is completely standard and straightforward. The relay is quickly detected and added to the system. On the plugin screen, the main control interface is displayed. At the top, a visual switch showing the relay's state, below, the energy monitoring indicators, and the current temperature. Control can be performed in two ways. You can tap the graphical image of the relay or use the button in the lower left corner. Each action, turning on or off, is accompanied by a pop-up confirmation, which prevents accidental activation. The settings menu here is standard and familiar from other Thuya devices. Several main options are available. Setting a countdown timer. Configuring the behavior after power restoration. The relay can always turn on, always stay off, or remember its last state. Adjusting the activity indicator behavior. It can reflect the relay's state, always stay on, always stay off, or work in sync with the switch position. The alarm setting section is responsible for the device's protective functions. Here you can set trigger thresholds for key parameters and choose whether the relay should automatically switch off when these limits are reached. The following threshold types are available: temperature, power, current, low voltage, and high voltage. In the additional settings, familiar Thuya Smart features are also available: grouping and sharing, automations, notifications, checking the current firmware version, and removing the device from the system. The relay can be used in automations. A wide range of parameters is available as triggers, relay state, timer, energy consumption, current, power, voltage, temperature, and alarms. For example, you can set triggers based on the relay's state, on-off, energy monitoring parameters, current, power, voltage, and specify value ranges, less than, greater than, within range, etc. Separate emergency events are also available: overcurrent, overvoltage, overpower, undervoltage, and others. The relay can also be used in automation actions, such as switching the relay on and off. However, as is often the case with relays, there is a noticeable lack of an option to toggle the state to the opposite or start a countdown timer. It's also possible to adjust calibration coefficients for voltage, current, and power, as well as define the relay's state, on, off, or remembering the last status. The relay is connected through a gateway that supports Matter, which is linked to multiple smart home systems. These slides show how the device appears in Google Home. The relay is correctly detected and can be controlled, but the functionality is limited. Only power on and off are available, without energy monitoring or other parameter display. A similar situation is observed in Apple HomeKit. The relay is successfully recognized through the Matter gateway, appears in the device list, and responds properly to commands. However, as in Google Home, only switching power on and off is available, with no access to additional parameters or statistics. The third system connected via the Matter gateway, or rather the fourth, if we count the base Thuya Smart, is Home Assistant. Here, the device is also correctly detected and displayed in the interface, but its functionality is identical to that in Google Home and Apple HomeKit. Now let's test how the device works in alternative systems. The relay was disconnected from the gateway and connected directly via ZHA, Home Assistant's native Zigbee integration. In this mode, the relay is correctly detected, power control is available, and energy monitoring sensors appear. In the configuration section, the main relay settings are available. Here, you can select the LED indicator behavior to stay lit when the relay is on, when it's off, or be completely disabled. Below is the power on state parameter, which defines how the device behaves after power restoration: turn on, stay off, or return to the last remembered state. When the child lock option is activated, the relay is forcibly turned off, and any attempts to switch it on, either via the interface or the physical button, have no effect. The device remains off until the protection is disabled. After the lock is removed, full control is restored. Now the relay is connected to Zigbee 2 MQTT, where it is recognized as MOES 5 with the model designation TS011F. Integration works smoothly. The device is natively supported, connects successfully, and immediately appears on the network as a Zigbee router. In the Exposes tab, all available device parameters are displayed. Here you can see the current temperature and set an overheat trigger threshold. Below that, thermal protection can be activated, so the relay will automatically switch off if the temperature is exceeded. Next are protection settings for power, current, and voltage. For each category, limit values can be set. Once exceeded, the relay automatically turns off. This allows flexible configuration of protection against overload, overvoltage, or undervoltage. Below is the main control block. Here, you can turn the relay on and off, set a countdown timer, configure behavior after power restoration, and adjust the LED indicator mode. At the bottom, real-time energy monitoring data is displayed, instantaneous power, current, voltage, and total energy consumption. There's also a Zigbee link quality indicator, allowing you to monitor the stability of the device's network connection. In Home Assistant, the device is integrated through MQTT. The control panel provides access to all major protection parameters. You can enable and configure thresholds for overheating, overvoltage, undervoltage, overpower, and overcurrent protection. The event log is also displayed here, recording every switching action. In the Sensors tab, current energy monitoring data is shown: current, power, voltage, temperature, and total consumption. Below are settings for power on behavior and LED indicator mode. Thus, the relay's full functionality is preserved when working through MQTT, including monitoring, protection, and configuration. To test the relay's operation in voltage protection mode, a simple test setup is used. The circuit includes a dimmer, which allows smooth adjustment of the voltage level, and a multimeter for accurate voltage measurement. An incandescent lamp is used as the load, making it easy to visually observe the moment when the protection is triggered as the voltage drops. Here you can see the basic principle of the test setup. After power is applied, the dimmer allows smooth reduction of the voltage level down to zero. Now the relay itself has been added to the circuit. It is installed after the dimmer, between the regulator and the load, i.e., the incandescent lamp. In the settings, the parameter responsible for switching off the relay when the voltage drops below a specified threshold has been activated. We turn on the relay and apply power to the load. At normal voltage, everything operates correctly. Then we gradually reduce the voltage, and after a short but noticeable delay, the relay switches off, responding to the voltage drop below the set threshold. After the voltage returns to normal, power is not automatically restored to the load. The relay must be turned on manually or through automation. A repeated test confirms the same result. The undervoltage protection works properly, but it triggers with a slight delay. The same test is repeated through the Zigbee 2 MQTT interface. And an interesting detail can be observed here. As the supply voltage decreases, the power reading starts to drop earlier than the voltage parameter. This means the system detects the load drop faster than the voltage reduction appears in the data. Only after some time does the voltage reading also reach the threshold level, after which the relay triggers and disconnects the power. In conclusion, this compact and affordable relay combines power control and energy monitoring functions. It displays key parameters: current, voltage, power, consumed energy, and body temperature. Additionally, the device supports setting thresholds for automatic shutdown in case of exceeding or dropping below preset values, adding a layer of protection. However, as shown in the tests, the protection response has a slight delay, which means it is not suitable for critical applications. It is also important to remember that the relay does not replace a circuit breaker and is not designed for short circuit protection. That function must be handled by a separate breaker in the circuit. It is also worth noting that the declared maximum current of 63 amperes raises some doubts. the relay's contact design is clearly not intended for such high loads during prolonged operation. Therefore, it is not recommended to use the device at its maximum rated power. The optimal solution is to connect it to separate circuits or outlets where the current does not exceed reasonable values, to avoid overheating and possible damage. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. It helps the channel grow and supports the video's visibility. To avoid missing new reviews and tutorials, subscribe and enable notifications. All links to the stores where you can purchase this relay, as well as my social media pages and smart home discussion group, can be found in the video description. Join in, it's going to be interesting. Thank you for watching. See you next time, and peace to everyone.